up, diba? Who among you are still sleeping here? Probably some, you know, analogy, you know, probably some of us are sleeping. You know, Paul begins with an alarm clock analogy. You know, in verse 11, that's what he said. The hour has already come for you to wake up from your slumber because our salvation is nearer than we first believed. Anytime between Jesus' ascension to heaven and his return from heaven is called the end times. Remember, from the time that the Lord Jesus Christ went back to heaven and from the time that he will return, that is considered the end times. So we are already on the end times. No one knows exactly how long this period of time will last, but it's all part of end times. So wherever we are right now, we are already on the end times. Now, the problem with the early Christian in Rome, they initially believed that Jesus would return immediately. Yun yung mindset nila. Inisip nila that Jesus Christ will return. But when he didn't return as they expected, some grew complacent and began to lose sense of commitment to their faith. Nahina na sila. Because akala, hindi pa naman darating. You know what? Okay, enjoy mo na ako. So that's how they feel. So that's the reason why Paul reminded them that they were ever nearer to their ultimate salvation, which is their heavenly home. And there are a few things that I would like to highlight on this verse. And number one is this: understanding the present time. Do we really understand what it means in our life? Are we understanding the present time? How do we know if we are fully understanding it? How can we say, oh, you know what, brother, I really understand the present time. How can we say that? Well, in order for us to answer that question, is we have to go back to yung binasa natin kanina, yung sa chapter 12. Sabi niya ganon, I therefore urge you, brothers and sisters, sabi niya, in the view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is a true and proper worship. Do not be conformed to the pattern of this age, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So, if we're going to claim that we already understand it, then yung renewing of the mind should be true to our life. That we should be already being transformed. Diba? Ito yung idea that, how can you say that you already understand it? Yeah, I understand it because I already renewed my mind. I have already been transformed. You know, renewing the mind equates understanding. If we are still doing the same thing and nothing has been transformed, then we haven't fully understood it yet. You know what I mean? Kung sinasabi natin na tayo eh, naiintindihan na natin yung mga bagay na to, but still we are still doing the same old thing that we do in the past, then I'm sorry to tell that, you know, nothing has been transformed, nothing has been changed, then that means you haven't fully understood it. Diba? So when we say we understand it, we already been transformed, right, in with our mind. We are no longer conforming on the pattern of this age. Number two, the thing that I would like to highlight is the hour has already come, you know, present. And how do we value time? Do we live it as this will be our last day? Or are we so lax? Have you asked the question, what if this will be my last year on the earth? Diba? 2017, we passed, and now we are on 2018. How sure are we that this will not be our last year? I hope that tayo, you know, we will meet at 2019. But there's no assurance, right? What if the rapture comes? Are we ready? Have we fully been utilized by the Lord to propagate His kingdom? Are we still in that mindset na, oh, let me just do it next month? Did you get me? Dumating na ba tayo dun sa punto? Did we came to that point na, you know what, I value this time, so I need to be used by the Lord. Diba? You know what, brother, next month na lang akong mag-ministry. O next month na lang akong kakanta. O next month na lang akong mag-Bible study. Next month, I'll do this. You know what, sabi niya gano'n, the hour has already come. This is the time. You know, remove that mindset that, you know, yung manyana habit. Dapat we have to do it now, right? If we are not going to do it now, the question is when? Kung hindi nyo gagawin ngayon, kailan nyo pa gagawin? Bukas? Baka bukas wala na kayong chance. You know, tumanda na kayo pero hindi kayo nagamit sa ministry ng Panginoon. And that will be sad, right? I hope as early as young as you are right now, mukha kayong bata, no? As early as right now, magamit na kayo. Huwag nyo nahintayin yung uugod-ugod na kayo, sasasabihin, saka yung pala ako magbabible study. Nasayang. Study, do it now. Let us not wait for the time until it's too late. And where we say, let us not wait and where we say, I hope I could have done something. Especially with our relatives, right? Do it now. Especially if they are not a believer yet or they haven't found the relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. Do it now. Sabi niya ganun, wake up from your slumber. You know, let us ourselves. Am I awake? Am I, or I'm still dreaming? Or, you know, bad or worse is, I'm still having a nightmare. Tanungin niya sa sarili niyo, gising na ba kayo? Are you already, or nananaginip pa rin? Are you still, you know, the hardest part about sleeping is that, you know, when you try to wake up a person that he was already awake, di ba mahirap gisingin, taong gising na eh. Yeah, the person was already awake. It's very hard to you know, alam niya na yung tama, alam niya na yung mali, pero nagmamali-malihan pa rin. Diba? Sabi niya ganun, our salvation is nearer now than when we first believed. So sabi niya, so don't be deceived. Do we have that kind of anticipation? Kasi sabi niya, in-anticipate ni Paul yan eh. Or are we the type of person that bargains last minute before he or she wakes up? Oh, mamaya na, konti na, 30 minutes na lang, inaantok pa ako eh. Diba? Or are we that type of person that who is so very excited? No, did you know that the most people who does that, alam niyo ba yung mata, you know those people who tries to, give me more 15 minutes. Or 10 minutes na lang. Or 5 minutes na lang. You know, the truth about that is those people, most of the time, those are the people who comes in late. Diba? Mas madalas yung mga tumatawad, sila yung nahuhuli sa trabaho. Maya-maya, late na. You know, we have to be anticipating, right? You know, did you know, have you imagined, let me ask Aileen, have you imagined the feeling that one morning you wake up and your kids are all prepared and ready? Talaga nakapis na, ready. Mami, tara na, nakakain na kami. Ayun, have we already taken a bath? How would you feel? You know, you will feel so glad and excited. Pero when you wake up in the morning and you're trying to drop your kids, gising na kayo, maliling na kayo, 5 minutes na lang. Magbe-bell na yung school. Diba parang it adds up the pressure. But when you see your kids all tied up and ready, wow, that's different. Huh? And that is the kind of anticipation the Lord wants from all of us. Yung bang sabi mo, Lord, tara na, ministry na, sama na ako dyan. Diba? Hindi yung, you know, sometimes the tendency, oh kapatid, do you want to join? You know what, let me pray for it first. Come on, diba? Grow up, let's wake up. You know, sabi niya ganun, the night is nearly over. Diba? Past is past. What did we learn from it? Don't look back. You know, what has been done is done, and what has been said. We need to focus on what is lies ahead. Three L's, okay? Three L's. Learn and live the past, live happily on the present, and look forward for the future. You know, learn from the past, live right now, look forward for the future. If there's something to learn from the past, then learn it. If there's something to correct, then correct it. But don't leave the past. Okay? Ang sabi niya ganun, the day is almost here. The promise of the future, a bright hope, a new opportunity. We always need to remember that behind that cloud, the sun is still shining. The truth of the matter is, okay, listen to this. And I want you to claim this. The truth of the matter is that blessings are all ready. Amen. It is us who are not. God is about to pour out His blessing, but the thing is that sometimes some of us are still sleeping. Ready na ibuhos ng Panginoon yung blessing niya. Kaya lang natutulog pa tayo. Diba? There's a joke. You know, when God pour out the blessing to have a handsome face, konti lang kaming gising. Joke lang. Pero that's the truth. We have to be ready. We have to be prepared because the Lord is always ready to pour out His blessing. But sometimes we are so lax. So sabi niya ganun, we have to be ready. So that is my first point. Okay? Mauubos na naman ako. Second point, clean up. Sabi ko kanina, wash, wake up and then clean up. Romans chapter 13, 12b to 13. So sabi niya, so let us put aside the deeds of the darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us behave decently as in the daytime, not in carousing and drunkenness, not in sexual immorality, and